Just now, we discussed policy iteration and value iteration, two fundamental algorithms in reinforcement learning. Next, we introduce the third algorithm, truncated policy iteration. I'd like to emphasize that the third algorithm is an extension of value iteration and policy iteration. In other words, value iteration and policy iteration are two special cases of truncated policy iteration. By introducing the third algorithm, we can better understand the difference and relationship between value iteration and policy iteration. First, let's quickly revisit value iteration and policy iteration. Policy iteration starts with an initial policy P0, which might be arbitrarily guessed. The kth iteration includes two steps: policy evaluation, where we solve V pi k from the Bellman equation for policy pi k, and policy improvement, where we solve an optimization problem to get a new policy pi k plus 1 based on V pi k, and then iterate further. Value iteration differs in its starting point. It doesn't start with an initial policy P0, but with an initial value V0. Iteratively, it converges to V star, the optimal state value. Its kth iteration also has two steps. The first step is policy update, where a new policy pi k plus 1 is derived from vk. The second step is value update. Based on pi k plus 1, we know these quantities. Also based on vk, I can calculate vk plus 1. Then, this process continues iteratively. At this point, some readers may have noticed the similarity between policy iteration and value iteration. To compare them, let's look at this expression. Policy iteration begins with a policy pi 0, undergoes policy evaluation to get v pi 0, then policy improvement to obtain pi 1, v pi 1, pi 2, v pi 2, and so on. By contrast, value iteration starts from a value u0, here to illustrate it starting from a value, not a policy. To compare the two algorithms, we forcibly align their starting points. Then alternates between policy update and value update, achieving a new policy and a new value. A new policy and a new value. In fact, these two algorithms are very similar. So, what is the difference between these two algorithms? This is a crucial question that leads to the core idea of truncated policy iteration. Let's examine this table. This column corresponds to the policy iteration algorithm and what each step does. This column corresponds to the value iteration algorithm and what each step does. We will carefully compare what is the same and what is different in each step. The first step is about policy. Policy iteration simply requires an initial policy, P0, whereas value iteration has not started yet because it does not need an initial policy. The second step is about value. Policy iteration aims to determine V0 by solving the Bellman equation. What about value iteration? It requires an initial value V0. To make these two algorithms comparable, we force V0 to be equal to V pi 0. In fact, the initial value for value iteration can be arbitrary. But if we start from an arbitrary initial value, we would not be able to compare these two algorithms. So I set V0 equal to V pi 0. The third step is about policy again. In policy iteration, we solve such an optimization problem to obtain a new policy pi 1 based on V pi 0. Value iteration is quite similar. We solve such an optimization problem to get a new policy, which is also exactly pi 1. Why? Because for the sake of comparison, I set V0 to equal to V pi 0. Up to this point, the steps of both algorithms are exactly the same, but differences emerge in the fourth step. How do they become different? For policy iteration, after obtaining pi 1, the next task is to obtain v pi 1 by solving the Bellman equation. In contrast, value iteration uses pi 1, these are all known, and v0 to get v1, and then uses this v1 immediately in the next step. This v pi 1 is also used in the next step. As a result, v1 and v pi 1 start to be different from this point onwards. If we continue the process, the new policies and values will also differ. So, the key is this step, that is the difference between VPi 1 and V1. We will take a closer look next. These are what I just introduced, so I will not repeat them here. Consider the step of policy iteration. It requires solving such a Bellman equation to find VPi 1. How to do it? we need a nested iterative algorithm, which we have already introduced before. I detail this nested iterative algorithm here for clarity. The notation v pi10 with a superscript 0 in parentheses indicates the initial estimate. Subsequent numbers 1, 2 represent the first, second estimates. Starting from any initial value, we substituted it into the equation to get v pi11, then v pi12, and so forth, until v pi1j. Eventually, we calculate an infinite number of times, leading to v pi1 infinite. The left-hand side becomes v pi1 infinite plus 1, which still represents an infinite estimate. This process is a classic iterative algorithm for solving the Bellman equation. This is not new but important for understanding how policy iteration uses a nested iterative process to evaluate the policy. Now let's consider something new. For comparison between policy iteration and value iteration, I've set the initial value for solving the Bellman equation in policy iteration equal to v0, where v0 is also the initial value for value iteration. If you look back at the table, you'll see that value iteration begins from this v0. Thus, by starting this process from v0, we're aligning the initial conditions for both value iteration and policy iteration. If vpi10 equals v0, which means it is v0, then vpi11 is essentially v1, which is the outcome of value iteration's first step. Value iteration immediately uses this v1 in the next policy update step. What about computing vpi1 infinite in policy iteration? In fact, that results in vpi1. Now it is clear. Value iteration computes just one step, while policy iteration computes infinitely many steps. Naturally, you might wonder if there's a middle ground. What if we only compute j steps and then treat vpi1j as a new quantity and use it in the next policy update step? This approach is what we call truncated policy iteration. It's termed truncated because it cuts off the steps from here to infinity, truncating the infinite series of steps after the jth iterations. Truncated policy iteration serves as a generalized form of both value iteration and policy iteration. That is because when j equals 1, truncated policy iteration becomes value iteration. When j approaches infinity, it becomes policy iteration. I want to emphasize an important point about policy iteration. Theoretically, policy iteration requires an infinite number of steps, but this is practically impossible. In reality, we cannot compute infinitely. Instead, we often compute a finite number of steps. For instance, we evaluate whether the difference between vpi1j and vpi1j minus 1 is sufficiently small. If it is, we stop iterating. So we're only computing a finite number of steps. Thus, in practical applications, what we use is a form of truncated policy iteration, even when we aim for policy iteration. This highlights the importance of the truncated policy iteration algorithm. These are the key points I just mentioned. This is the pseudocode for truncated policy iteration. It is the same as the pseudocode for policy iteration that we discussed earlier. The only difference lies here. Instead of determining if the state value has converged, we check whether we have executed the predefined number of iterations. For example, we predefined a number of iterations which can be 1, 2, 100, or 1000. If the number of iterations reaches this predefined threshold, we stop and proceed to the next policy update step with the calculated value vkj plus 1. At this point, the obtained vkj plus 1 is taken as a new value vk. Then I use it in the next step to calculate the policy. How should we choose the parameter j truncate? We will illustrate this through an example. One may ask a question. If we don't compute an infinite number of steps, the vk we calculate is actually not v pi k. Then, does truncation bring problems? For example, could it cause the entire algorithm to no longer converge? Answering this question is complex. Here, we only provide a relatively simple result to give you an intuitive explanation. What is this result? It is related to solving the Bellman equation. Now we have an iterative algorithm. If the initial value of this iterative algorithm is v pi k minus 1, then we can prove that v pi kj plus 1 is definitely greater than v pi kj. So each calculation will increase its value, whether calculated one time or j times or infinitely. Calculating an infinite number of times would be very costly, so we don't do it. Calculating a finite number of steps is sufficient. For the proof of this result, you can refer to my book. This suggests that truncated policy iteration is practical and important, since it can balance computational efficiency and the accuracy of the value. The results we just discussed can be better illustrated by a figure. The horizontal axis is k, which is the iteration index. The vertical axis is the values. For the sake of simplicity, we only consider a one-dimensional state value. The red line represents the optimal state value, labeled as v star. The purple line represents vk, the values obtained from value iteration, which gradually converge towards v star, starting from a certain point. V pi k represents the outcomes obtained from the policy iteration algorithm, which also converges to V star. The black line represents truncated policy iteration. This approach calculates a finite number of steps such as J in every iteration. Thus, it is higher than Vk, but lower than V pi k, positioning it between policy iteration and value iteration. Since both the blue and purple lines converge, it is reasonable to infer that the black line also converges. This concludes all the content for today's lecture. Let's briefly recap what we have studied. First, we introduced the concept of value iteration. This algorithm was actually introduced in our previous lecture. In this lecture, we presented a detailed analysis of it and assigned it a name called value iteration. It has two steps in every iteration. The second algorithm we introduced today is policy iteration. It's very important. And in our next lecture, we will build upon it to derive model-free reinforcement learning algorithms. The third algorithm is truncated policy iteration. We now know that, in fact, these two are the extreme special cases of truncated policy iteration. That's all for today's content. See you next time.